In this video, we're going to be looking at grids, guides, and canvas bounds. The first one that we're going to talk about is grids. Grids is a Rebelle created line. We're going to choose View, Show Grid, which is keyboard shortcut Shift G. Now you can see that Rebelle has added these grids onto the canvas. These will not show up if you print or you export the image here. These are just for your reference. If you draw, it will snap to the grid. You can turn on or off, snap to grid. If this is turned off, then when you draw, it won't have any effect on your drawing. Let's undo that. To change the property of the grid, we can go to Edit, Preferences, Grids and Guides. And up here at the very top, you can see the different guides. Now split canvas evenly, vertical 8. Let's bring this down to 3 and 4 and click OK. The canvas has been divided into a grid of 3x4. Let's go back into preferences and let's change the style to a solid line. You can see that reflected here. So we're going to choose split canvas into units of length. Now the line, that's line here, every 100 pixels, subdivisions, that's right here, this is blue, this is red. We're gonna click on OK, and you'll see every 100 pixels, there's a red line. And this is starting from the left top corner, and inside, there's 3 subdivisions across and down. Now, if we turn this off and go to split canvas evenly, this is where we can decide how many boxes are in the grid. And again, to snap to a grid, just turn on this option right here in the view menu. Now let's talk about guides. The keyboard shortcut for this is Shift U. And what you see is we don't see something automatically because we haven't created them. Guides are user created. So they're similar to grids. If we tap right here, we'll turn guides on. Now if I drag to the right, hovering, when I tap on the screen, it'll create a new guide. If I come over here to the left side and drag down, I can do the same thing and create guides on my own. If I tap on the canvas, I can create guides here. And these can snap to other guides if we turn on View, Snap to Guides. Now, when I click here and I get close to a guide, it will snap to it. In order to move a guide, you can touch on the node and drag it. To remove it, you can drag the whole thing off. Notice it turns red. When you release, it will delete. You can click on the Edit Guide button here in the corner to turn off editing of the guides. If you want to draw directly on the guide, snap to Guides. We'll make sure that when you're drawing, it will attach to the guide. If you're on a guide and you get to the end of a guide, you'll stop snapping to it when you get past the edge. Let's go ahead and undo that. You can select, if we turn on Edit Guides again, we select it. We can also remove it by clicking the Delete key. And let's turn off Edit Guides by clicking again in the corner. Guides, just like grids, don't display when you export or you print your canvas. Now, guides have options for color, opacity, lines, active line. This would be a line that we select. Let's go ahead and make this very clear. And width is how wide. We can select up to 5 pixels wide the line is. So we're going to turn on View, Show, Guides. And let's create one on the canvas. What you'll notice is that this line, when active, is now red, and it's thicker because we've changed the guide width from 3 to 5. Let's go ahead and select this one and press the delete key. We'll turn off edit guides. And now let's move on to canvas bounds. View, show, canvas bounds. So this is turned on. Canvas bounds will not be visible unless we're using something that uses canvas bounds. So we're going to do something here. We're going to draw a little circle here in the center and put an X here right in the middle. Now we're going to go over here to the canvas and we're going to select use deckled edges. And then we go over here into settings, into preferences. Here you can see canvas bounds. Snap to, we have the bounds, we have center, thirds, and quarters. The color, we have green. Let's make this something a little more visible. We're going to make it a dark red. Width, again, we can choose wider or narrower. And let's bring the opacity up to 100 to make this very easy to see. And let's turn on Snap to Canvas Bounds. We're going to choose the Transform tool. Here, if I bring this to the center, you'll see that we have the orange snapping guides. If we bring this over to the corner here, you can see that these canvas bounds are just outside of the visible canvas. And this is showing us the actual boundaries of the canvas itself. Now here in Preferences, we have our very last option, snapping lines. These we saw when we were moving around and snapping to the canvas bounds. You could see that our snapping lines were showing us where we were snapping to. All right, you guys, that's it for grids, guides, and canvas bounds. If you have questions, put it in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.